Good morning, my dear students. In the last class, we have seen the compounds or molecules with the total number of atoms. Am I right? Are you able to find out the total number of atoms in a molecule? 7H2O. For example, 7H2O contains 7 into 2 hydrogen atoms plus 7 oxygen atoms. That is 7 into 2, 14 plus 7. 21 is the total number of atoms present in that 7H2O. Is it clear? I think you understood that taking the total number of atoms in a molecule. Now we can see some of the compounds with their component elements. See this one, compound molecules and atoms. Carbon dioxide is a compound which contains carbon and oxygen. Then hydrogen chloride, hydrogen and chlorine are the component elements. Then water contains hydrogen and oxygen. Then sugar, the formula is C12H22O11. So carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are present in that sugar. Then mercuric oxide containing mercury and oxygen. So these are some of the compounds. Then what do you mean by a compound? A compound is formed by the combination of two or more elements. Some of the compounds containing two elements, some are having three elements. Is it clear or not? Some of the compounds are formed by the combination of two elements and some are formed by the combination of three elements. Here sugar contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Is it clear? This mercury oxide contains only mercury and oxygen. Is it clear or not? So compounds are formed by the combination of two or more elements. So these are the atoms present in that compounds. So we have already learned how can we calculate the number of atoms in each molecule. You have seen already. Now we can see some of the chemical equations. See, 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. So these are some of the chemical equations. Then in the chemical equation, there are reactants and products. Then what do you mean by reactants? Reactants are the substances taking part in the chemical reaction. Reactants are the substances taking part in the chemical equation or chemical reaction. So which are the elements taking part in a chemical reaction? In the first equation, hydrogen and oxygen are taking part in the chemical reaction. So these are called reactants and this water is the product. What do you mean by the products? The substance obtained as a result of the chemical reaction is called the products. Did you understand? So in a chemical equation, there are reactants and products. On the left hand side, we are writing the reactants by putting the plus mark in between these elements. And on the right hand side, after the arrow mark, we are writing the products. So reactants and products are there in a chemical equation. So what are reactants? Reactants are the substances taking part in a chemical reaction. So in the second equation, nitrogen and hydrogen are taking part in the chemical reaction. And ammonia is the product. NH3 is the product. Then the third equation, sodium and chlorine are the reactants which are taking part in a chemical reaction. And the result or the product is NaCl. Clear or not? Okay, so what do you mean by reactants? Reactants are the substance taking part in a chemical reaction and the products are the substance formed after or as a result of the reaction is called the products. Is it clear or not? Then if I am giving an equation, how can you say which are the ones reactants and which are the ones products? Clear? Okay, then we can see. See this equation, Zn plus HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. This is an equation, but it is not a balanced chemical equation. What do you mean by balanced chemical equation? In a balanced chemical equation, the number of reactants on the left hand side is equal to the number of reactants or number of elements on the right hand side. Here one Zn and here also one Zn. Here H1, here H2 is there. Then chlorine 1 is here, but chlorine 2 is here. So this is not a balanced equation, but we can say that it is a chemical equation. Is it clear or not? So how can we find out the chemical equation is a balanced one? Then what do you mean by it? So balanced equation is a chemical equation in which the number of reactants or number of reactant part atoms on the reactant part equal to the number of atoms on the product part. That means in a balanced equation, see this one, this is a balanced equation. So Zn plus 2HCl gives Zn Cl2 plus H2. Zn only one, then 2H is here also 2H, then 2Cl is here also 2Cl. So this is the balanced equation. So balanced equation is an equation when a chemical equation is written the number of atoms of the same kind on the side of the reactants and that of the product should be equal. This type of chemical equations are called balanced chemical equation. So this is written as the balanced equation for this first reaction. Is it clear or not? So how can we balance it? So we can see in the next class. How can we balance the chemical equations? We can see in the next class.